I was in Vegas recently. A lot of douchery in Vegas. Thank you. I feel like people go to Vegas to be a douche, you know? Like, I kind of feel sorry for Vegas in that way. We've just chosen this place we go and, like, smear our asshole all over, you know? It's not really Vegas's fault. We've just decided that when we want to be a complete dick, we go to Vegas and do it there, you know? It's funny, like, sometimes you'll see somebody at home and they seem like an okay person, and then you see them in Vegas and you're like, holy shit, like... I saw this guy I knew there, like, he seemed like pretty normal guy. I see him in Vegas, he was like so drunk, he's like wet, like just like falling through the casino. I'm like, I'll see you back home, Scott. You need to work through some shit, clearly. I was just sitting by the pool with my friends and these guys walk up to us, my favorite types, like young, date raping jocks, just some guy looks like he just graduated from rape tech or some shit. And he was so drunk, he was sort of gently swaying, just my type. And he walked up and he goes, what are you two lovely bitches doing? He called us lovely bitches, which is also a poem by Emily Dickinson. And he goes, I would actually like to have sex with both of you ladies. He said it like it was a special Christmas offer. And then he goes, I bet you don't know what Vegas is all about. I was like, I don't know. You explain it to me. My tits are confused. And he goes, Vegas is actually about sex and money, ladies. He said it like that was a real breakthrough concept to come out about Vegas. I'm like, isn't that pretty much what it says on the brochure?
But I thought Vegas was about eating organic and unconditional love. I thought Vegas was supposed to be all about loyalty and trust. Oh, if what you say is true, we've got to tell the detectives and fast. Even my tits are concerned.
He did not care for me at all. He was a real prince. He was the one that got away, is what he was. He just goes like this to me. He goes, He tried to erase me like I was a chalkboard. I've never been manually erased before, but it's not a good feeling. And then he got frustrated when he couldn't erase me. He's like, what the fuck? I can't erase this bitch. Get over here, Tucker. I can't erase her.